everybody, it's the Walker. So what are we doing today? Well, once again, we're hiking in the woods. And this brings up a topic, the Firesteel. We've all seen it. You just lost it. Where is it? I don't know. Question is, what happens at night? It's gonna get a whole lot worse. And we know if you lose the Firesteel, you're in for a world of trouble. I mean, you can't always just tap out. So let's get up a little higher on this hill, maybe get a little fire going, and we'll talk about Firesteel lanyards at night. First thing, I don't think you can actually have a video about Firesteel stuff without actually starting a fire. I lost my last Core 4 stove, so I had to buy a new one. I don't know where it went to. So let's go, we're gonna do that yellow birch bark. There we go. In we go. Bingo. They do work, they do work. Uh-oh. If you can hear that, that's a black helicopter is after me again. Oh, they follow me around 24/7. Hope they don't see the smoke. Yellow birch bark. All right, with that out of the way, which I believe should be the prerequisite on any video involving firecraft, you kind of got to start a fire, right? Let's go over Firesteel lanyards for night. Lots of Firesteels you can get. They come black, wood tone colors. Look at this one. Hey, this is not a bad Firesteel, but that's black. That's black. You know, whoa. During the daytime, it's kind of problematic, but at night, you're really gonna have some trouble with that, you know? Here's one that a friend made for me. This is really gonna disappear at night. Now, some of the companies have gotten a little wise to the fact that you don't want to lose your Firesteel. Wow, that's a good fire. In fact, a little bit too good. So, what they've done, here's one that's in orange. Even has a little orange lanyard thing on it. Actually, a little, so you don't lose the top. That's a little better. Here's a couple Light My Fires. I mean, they're not exactly stellar bright colors, but it's a lot better than that, right? Now, my own personal Firesteels, I've been using yellow cordage. It's starting to get a little canoe action there. And here's a magnesium fire block with Firesteel on it. And this has been pretty good. But for over the summer, I've been doing a lot more of night hiking, night running, going to the camp late at night, setting up camp at night. And it got me thinking, if I lose these Firesteels, it's easy enough during the day to put something down and have it vanish. But what about at night when the loss factor quadruples? I mean, you lose your Firesteel, I can't just, you know, with the term tap out. I'm in the middle of the woods, right? I've got more than one way to start a fire, but still, just on principle, it's not something I want to deal with. So what I did for this test, I made three Firesteels. These are big Firesteels. One, two, three. Three big Firesteels right there. These are 1/2 inch by 5 inch fire steels. I bought the fire steel blanks, then I made a bent kydex, then riveted I think it's a number 8 grommet, and then I put Gorilla Glue in there. This ain't coming out. This ain't coming out ever. So we made 3 of them for this test. 1, 2, 3. 3 big fire steels, identical. Now, what to do, hold on a second, I gotta tend my little fire. What to do though for the actual lanyard material? Because that's what this is all about. There we go. We got a couple options. There's solid, there's basically non-reflective. This is some kind of weird blue with a little bit of gray and a little bit of white in there. It's got an interesting pattern to it. Bright international orange. Look at that. And there's always black. This is a 550 paracord. And there's also reflective options where the light will bounce off of it. This is not paracord, but it is green cordage with, it has a core to it, and it's highly reflective. This is paracord. It's also a bright color, but I would say more of a little lighter than the international orange, and it has semi-reflective. It's got a little bit of reflective nature to it, but not a lot, but it does have reflective bands on it. And here's cordage. This is not paracord, but it's just regular, I don't know, some kind of generic type cordage. Highly reflective. And it has a core, so it's not weak or anything like that. So there's a bunch of options out there to make a lanyard. Now, before we talk about the lanyard, let's talk about the breakaway. This is a flashlight, well, obviously, but flashlights go on my body, like this. In case I'm in the woods, get the flashlight on, I drop it, there it is. However, because it's attached to my body, I want a breakaway option. Because if I get hung up in the mountain laurels, fall down a ledge or something like that, and this thing is jammed into a rock, it could break my wrist. Therefore, this flashlight has a single strand of paracord right there, snap off. It's also attached to a little wire thing right there. And the back has this little holder, which would just snap right off. Whoa. Let's get this fire under control. There we go. So if I got hung up in a tree, ba-bam, that's it, you know? Now, granted, the light's gonna fall. It's got a really tough recessed switch here. So odds are, it's still gonna be on when it hits the deck, I'll be able to find it. And if I can't, it's not a good situation, but it's a lot worse than, you know, actually a lot better than losing my wrist, you know? And some of these lanyards, especially for flashlights, you know, put them around your neck. This is a wrist one, so it's not gonna fit my neck, but I do have ones that go around my neck. Those are also breakaway. But for the fire steel does not go on my body. The fire steel, is it gonna loop around a belt and then go into my pocket? Maybe loop around like a belt loop and into my pocket, or maybe I'll loop it around like inside of a pack loop and then put it in my pack. So this is not on my body. Therefore, I don't feel a need for a breakaway option. I mean, if it rips my belt loop off, you know, so what? If it tears off a pack loop, so what? But I want it to be real secure. But because it's not on my body, I don't have a breakaway. But if you do decide for some reason to put this on your body, please put a breakaway. You know, we don't want any of that. So let's discuss what I did for my fire steel options for night. One option I did right here is the yellow or zombie green. You do know this is the international color of zombies, right? Now, this is non-reflective. Still, I wanted to test it out to see how it would work at night. So, and I used a long length. All these lanyards are long. Gives me plenty of options to loop things around without fiddling or anything like that. Of course, as I said, Don't loop this on your body because there's no breakaway for it. But I still wanted extra line on it. And of course, I could put a striker on here as I did here. I happen to use the back of my knife, which has been filed for that purpose. So I don't do that, but hey, you know, let's tend the fire for a second. Okay, where were we? All right, my next option, which I chose, is the highly reflective paracord. Just a straight up highly reflective paracord. That's my next option I chose to test out. This isn't paracord. It's just some kind of regular generic cordage, but it has a core to it. Just it doesn't have the number of strands. It's just one thick strand in the middle there, or a couple strands, but it's not actually legitimately paracord. But still, it's not gonna break for this fire steel. It's actually pretty thick. All right, so this is highly, highly reflective. Hey, there we are. Okay. My next option I chose is the international orange, but with the green, highly reflective cordage, just for a loop like that. So you have one loop and then another loop. So I kind of have both the reflective cordage and the regular cordage, and of course it's long. There we go. So we tested all three of these out at night. Now, of course, you know you're gonna see the footage of that at the end of this video. All right, so 1, 2, 3. What did I use to try to find these? Well, I used a headlamp. I used a Fenix HL30, I believe, headlamp. Why? Because, one, it's a really cool headlamp. Look, hey, that's a cool headlamp, right? But more importantly, it's got a wide, floody beam, and it's not wildly overly powerful. I think it was a good representative of what a lot of headlamps do. Wide, floody beam. You know, it's pretty powerful, but not like a super special powerful. So I think it was a good representative of what, you know, your classical headlamp is in 2016. Even has a weird red, which I don't use. All right. So, what did I find when I actually tested these things out in the woods? We tested it out in three different types of environments. One was the middle of a trail, as if I just dropped it in the middle of the trail. I actually backpack ran in 2 miles to get some distance away from everything on a trail, actually on a dirt road, then to a trail. And what we did is we placed all three of these directly in the middle of the trail, as if I was sitting down like now. Let's say I sat down, cooked some food or something like that, and then I got up and left, and of course, like the goober, I just left the fire steel there. What did I find when I put them both in all three in the middle of the trail? One, they're all three were easy to find because they're in the middle of the trail and they're all brightly colored. These two reflected cordage showed up so far away it was ridiculous. Even the little bit of reflective cordage was actually enough to make all the difference in the world. I mean, having more reflective cordage was better, but just a little loop really made a difference. And this orange actually worked out, actually not orange, zombie green, that's what it is, zombie green worked out very good just out in the open with a flashlight, actually the headlamp. Can't complain, we're good. Next thing we did is we placed it in the leaf litter with some growth, as if we were bushwhacking, off trail, bushwhacking, and we dropped our fire steel. Or we sat down to do something, got up and dropped our fire steel. So there was some, mostly leaves, but there was also some little fern action, and a couple little brush action. Now this test was really compelling in that when I put it down, I hiked away and didn't come back. I had no idea where the actual fire steels were because I lost my way, right? So I actually had a real live test. And without the reflective cordage, I would never have found it. I mean, maybe eventually I could have blundered into it, but this cordage showed up so far, it was ridiculous. The yellow cordage or zombie green. That showed up okay once I was like 15 feet away, but man, these two cordages right here, it's like 100 feet away, maybe more, and I could see them so far off, it was just ridiculous. And again, the more reflective cordage, the better, but this little loop, it showed up fairly well. The little loop, it showed up good. And of course, I saw the bright cordage when I got closer, but I found the zombie green was actually more effective than, at least, of course, this all is a matter of interpretation because everybody sees things a little bit differently. I found the zombie green to be more effective than the international orange or blaze orange or whatever you want to call it. Oh, maybe about like 4 or 5 feet or something like that. So either a big length of bright cordage or a little loop, they both worked really good. Next test was I jogged up onto the dirt road, and on the side of the dirt road there was higher, different, like maybe golden rods and higher brush. And I was trying to represent if I got off an ATV, got off a vehicle, or stopped and rest by the road, and I put it into the higher brush on the side of the road, because often dirt roads will have higher stuff growing at the very margin than you'll find in the middle of the woods. And here's what happened. So I placed it there, hiked back into the trail, then jogged up the trail onto the dirt road and jogged down the dirt road. What did I find? Well, I found this had pretty much disappeared. Even though once I got close to it, I was able to see it. Whoop, and it went. This, the longer lanyard, all this, I could see this so clear, because although this went into the weeds, there's still plenty of this like long lanyard hanging out, and it shines so bright against the light of my headlamp. This particular one, the mix, this one here, the reflective part went into the deeper brush, gone. You know, it basically was no more, I mean, not that much more better to see than the straight color, although once I got close to it, and I could get the right angle where it wasn't being obstructed by any brush or anything like that, that reflective cordage really showed up. All right, so the general gist, one, if you take your Firesteel out at night, or maybe just for regular use, because you never know when you end up out at night, right? I'd highly recommend some reflective cordage rather than just straight, you know, bright cordage. If you get straight bright cordage, you know, orange, better than black. But strangely enough, this weird zombie green really showed up well, even against green foliage. Kind of surprised me. Or, you know, is what it is. Another thing I discovered is, although more bright reflective cordage is better than a little bit of reflective cordage on a brightly colored lanyard, a little bright cordage goes a long way. So if you don't feel like doing your entire lanyard in this reflective type cordage, just a little loop like this. And the fact that this is green had no bearing on anything, because we have this bright color right here for either during the day or at night. But a little reflective cordage like that, for a lot of situations, made all the difference in the world. So what I'm planning on doing is I'm going to trade out this yellow or zombie green, which is still good, on all mine, with probably gonna go with this cordage right here. It's highly reflective. Orange cordage, although I found the yellow cordage to be a little bit better during the day than a solid cordage. This stuff is so visible at night, it's just ridiculous. Another thing I'm going to do is these fire steels right here, which are more natural in nature, I'm going to put a little loop of either this or this on it. So, you know, probably go with something like this, or maybe even this stuff right here, even though it doesn't have a really big reflective area, it's just a thin stripe, it still shows up on this. This way I have both the advantages if I drop it during the day or if at night. So just a little loop, because I like the way these things look. I don't want to change out the entire lanyard, but I don't want to lose it either. So all right, so those are my findings. I don't know if I was like clear and concise on what I'm saying here. But in any case, up next is the actual field testing. So take a look. If you enjoyed what you've seen, give me a thumbs up. And as always, have a great day.